testing palmar abduction, also known as thumb abduction. Patient will be in a seated position with the hand in a supinated position. First thing you will have your patient do is perform thumb abduction towards the ceiling. So go ahead and do that, Rachel, as far as you can go, and bring it on down. Because she was able to do that, I would count that as a grade 3. And because she did that, I would proceed forward to grade for a 4 or 5. So how I would do that is I'd have the patient bring their thumb into the same position, but only halfway. I would stabilize the forearm just proximal to the wrist, and then I will add resistance to the thumb just proximal to the MP joint here. Okay, Rachel, I want you to resist me. 3, 2, 1. Very good, bring it down. If she could not bring her thumb into abduction, then I would have her in a gravity eliminated position. Looks like this, shown here. Go ahead, perform thumb abduction for me, Rachel, and then bring it back. Because she was able to perform this, I would count that as a grade 2. If she could not, then I would palpate this muscle right here, which is the abductor pollicis brevis. If I feel that muscle firing, that'd be a grade 1, and if I do not feel it firing, that is a grade 0.